Hello everyone, my name is Ronald Fields. I'm going to be your instructor for the term. This is for Literary Theory of the Summer 2018. I wanted to post a brief video here so that we can go over a few things about Moodle. It's recently gone through a major revision and it looks a little different than what you're used to. So what I want to do as briefly as I can is give you an overview of the course, the layout of the course in Moodle, and go into a little bit of detail about the discussion forums that we're going to be engaging. Whenever you log in to Moodle, your screen will look similar to this with your messages on the right, the courses you're taking on the left. Just click on our course, Literary Theory. On the very first page, don't worry about task screen access, we're not using that. There's not a whole lot of information right here. When you click on course home, there's some very important information. There's my name, phone number, that is my cell phone, and I'm available pretty much any time. I don't always answer, but if you leave me a message, I will definitely give you a call back. You can also shoot me an email if you need to as well. This semester, I'm going to be on the vast majority of the time, probably 5 to 7 days a week at different times. But from 2 to 3 on Tuesdays and Thursdays, I'll be sitting in front of my computer with my phone on me, going through coursework and so on. So you can actually reach me then, and I will definitely answer. Scrolling down, the instructor information is more of the same. There are documents here that are very important. The course syllabus, which you need to take a look at. Course policies as well. This folder is called course documents, and you're going to refer to this several times. If you click on course documents, you'll find the rubric that I use for grading your combined application paper document. The discussion rubric, how I grade your weekly discussions. And you'll have 2 discussion posts every week, as well as a combined application paper, and we'll go over that shortly. There are some PowerPoints. The dates on these are wrong because we've switched to a 14-week schedule instead of 15 weeks for this semester. So like week 9 is actually week 8, week 10 is actually week 9, and so on. These have been duplicated with the correct dates in each week. Going back to course home, as I said before, make sure you view the syllabus, the course policies, and the course documents. You need to do all that during this first week. And there's a link for the Tiffin library, which you can use for extra research when needed for your papers. You click on Writing Helps. There are some tips there. Turnitin assignment submission and overview. You can read that. How we grade your writing and so on. There's the rubric as well. You have a combined application paper outline rubric once again. A pre-formatted academic paper. We do use MLA in this class. And there are some graduate writing handouts which might be helpful for you. Now, week 1, general course introduction, always make sure that you read these. Sometimes it's a lecture, sometimes it's just helpful notes, but you can just click read more to get some more information. This is probably very important. Each week you're going to have 2 discussion posts and a Turnitin assignment due. The first discussion post will be an outline of the material you've read for the week. Generally, each outline work should be a minimum of a half a page, single space, though you will likely find writing much longer outlines helpful. I'm going to show you a couple of sample combined documents in a few moments that will kind of give you an idea of what I'm looking for this class. So the first discussion post for each week, beginning with week 2, when we start in the actual readings, your first discussion post will always be an outline of the material. Your second discussion post will be a good draft of an application paper. This is where you take one part of a theory that we've read for the week and apply that to a creative work of your choice. Students have written on visual arts, poetry, music, fiction, creative nonfiction, architecture, sculpture, films, television shows, comic books. I mean, if it's a creative work, you can apply a theory to it. Not all theories, obviously, are going to work for every countryman, but not all theories are going to work for every creative work, but as an example, let's say that you're applying Aristotle's definition of rhetoric to Mark Antony's Friends, Romans, Countrymen speech in Julius Caesar. Your paper should help us better understand both Aristotle and Mark Antony. The application paper that you post to the discussion forum should be nearly complete and thorough, though you'll have a day or so to make changes and upload the finished version. So the point of these application papers is so that we better understand the theory and the creative work. The theory helps us to understand the creative work, and the creative work helps us to understand the theory. They work together. For week one, we have an introductory discussion. Each discussion post will always give you instructions. So here's your instructions for the initial post, what we want you to do. And then you need to have secondary posts. That's where you reply to peers. There's always instructions for each one, tells you how to do it, how to update your profile on this first one. They've always got due dates. For this first discussion post, where we're just introducing ourselves, you need to have your introduction done by roughly midnight Wednesday, 11:55 p.m. Eastern Time on Wednesday. And then by 11:55 p.m. on Saturday, you have read and responded to however many are required. Looking through here, it should tell you how many. Writing requirements. In addition to one initial post, respond to at least three peers for this first one.